Reverend Aniyedi Okule, the executive director, African Faith and Justice Network, which is based right here in the nation's capital of Washington, D.C. Well, it's always a pleasure, of course, to host you on Straight Talk Africa, Reverend Okule.
Thank you. I'm delighted to be here. Thank you for your graciousness and for the great work you do for VOA. I'm delighted to be here. I'm honored to be here.
You're most welcome, sir.
Thank you.
Later in the program, we'll give our audience a chance to call in with your question or comment. The number to call is 202-619-3111, and the U.S. country code is 1. I honestly wish that Ambassador Kwate was here, because he would be really the one to answer the critical question whether or not the African Union is doing what it is expected to do. What about you? You've been an observer of the Continental Institution. What does it strike you like? What is the significance of the African Union, really?
You know, a union per se, the African Union per se, it's a wonderful body to have. It is there supposedly to bring the continent together, the various countries together, to promote in some of the 14-point reason for the AU, to promote unity, to promote economic cooperation, to promote security, to engage in the promotion and protection of human and people's rights, which the countries have adopted, and to promote sustainable development within the continent. As an observer, I don't see that happening. It hasn't happened in the way that one would expect a continent that size, 55 countries, great diversity of economic bloc, diversity of people, mineral resources, and very rich in so many ways. Why has it not happened? In my own assessment, I think that the players, the government, the leaders of the countries are still very much interested in their own personal gains to a large extent. Not everyone, some are trying, but in general, there is an inner focus, my gains over the gains of first the country they represent and the continent to which they belong. That's what I see. The second thing is that when you look at the issue of sustainable development that they say they want to have, and economic corporations, most African countries are quicker, faster to have agreements with countries outside of the continent than the countries next door.
In a bilateral context.
Yeah, in a bilateral context, yes. You know, you have sometimes the governments tend to go back to the former colonial masters, the respective former colonial masters, to establish links with them rather than forge relationships with the people next door, which is something that truly, truly will enhance the welfare of the continent and the people living in that country.
Now, you know, of course, that there was another institution before the founding of the African Union. Mm-hmm. We should point out, by the way, that the African Union was actually founded in
2001.
It was founded in 2001, yeah, in Addis Ababa, mm-hmm, but it was launched in 2002. Was,
yeah,
it in Durban?
Yep, exactly. Okay,
yes. South Africa.
Okay.